On channel 6, that's our emergency channel. All just right. Come back to the bus and turn the key on the accessories and call up the reception and the cavalry will come out here to save us.
All right. That's a good feeling.
Yeah. I've used it a couple of times. It's a little wide bit on the ends of the sea. That's all the spear grass.
Okay.
Righto. Hold your hand out. Get rid of that. Roll your fingers down a bit, open your hand up a little bit. Feel them moving?
Yeah.
They're trying to plant themselves.
Okay.
They actually, see how they're all moving?
Yeah.
They've hit the moisture,
yeah.
And they're trying to grow into your skin. And what happens is actually, if you get it in your skin,
yeah.
You actually got to cut it out. Yeah. See how it's all moving? That's because water's hit it. That's what it's
moving. Yeah.
Yeah. So that's it. It's a self-planting seed. So on the ground, it digs itself into the ground and plants itself.
Okay.
How good's that? The only downside of doing that
is
your hand's going to be hairy for the rest of your life now. But when you have a shave, you'll have to shave your hand.
I will not do that.
I realise the only people we'll see today is possibly some national parks and wildlife rangers, or maybe a bus on bedrock. So they've got quite a good management plan in place for these trees, and they've had the trees for quite a long time.
We'll see if we can't sneak over this afternoon. I might be able to take out and show you that. Got enough time. We'll wander down to the tube, maybe.
Then on, of course, the Gulf Development Road out to Mount Surprise, the way you're going to go out to Georgetown and that.
Mm-hmm.
Road into Undara, that's where we're all staying here at Undara. That's the ancient mountain range I spoke about earlier on, being 3 to 5 kilometres behind what it is today. Mm-hmm. We're out here at Wind Tunnel, so we drove out here, we're going to pull up the airport on the way back. Drove out here checking the Wind Tunnel, we're going to go to the airport, back down here and have afternoon tea, then we're going to go down and have a look at Road Tube, and which is pretty special to see that. And maybe on across the Gulf Development Road out to Mount Surprise, the way you're going to go out to Georgetown and that.
Mm-hmm.
Road into Undara, that's where we're all staying here at Undara. That's the ancient mountain range I spoke about earlier on, being 3 to 5 kilometres behind what it is today. Mm-hmm. We're out here at Wind Tunnel, so we drove out here, we're going to pull up the airport on the way back. Drove out here checking the Wind Tunnel, we're going to go to the airport, back down here and have afternoon tea, then we're going to go down and have a look at Road Tube. So which is pretty special to see that.
Perfect.
Big deal.
There was nothing.
Big deal. Go to bed at 9 o'clock for mine. Wake up at 7. Perfect.
Yeah, and you don't. Yeah, I know what you're saying. It's just really, really good.
I was when I came back tonight. I was so relaxed.
So I got you know Fraser Island.
Yeah.
Well, I've got a house at Harvey Bay.
Yeah.
And my friend owns.
The history of the states, it was the same people, the same origin on Mars who came off, and they had an awful amount of battle.
Well, they had a lot of trouble with the on the over.
Dangerous snakes?
Some of them, huh?
Some.
Only about 6 or 7 of the most deadliest snakes in the world, would you?
Yeah.
Yes, we know.
Best part of living in Australia. Bit of excitement happens over here. Couldn't imagine what it's like living in a boring country. If you want your camera to work down here, put that on.
Yeah, it's already on manual.
Put your lens on manual. Got autofocus and manual, put it on manual. And we'll take the photo now.
Beautiful. Great. Absolutely great.
It's all part of my office.
Yeah.
Unreal. And here. Yeah. Look at them.
Yeah,
unreal, isn't it?
So.
Incredible to see, isn't it?
Yeah.
Had that snakey up down the wall. Look up above us. Look at that. Oh. Push the roof up. Big gas bubble. Beautiful, isn't it? Up here you see there's holes, gas chambers. Hard to imagine the stuff being flexible enough that the gas will just push it up in the air, right? And
what is that tree for a special shape?
That's a real different one. That's a Queensland bottle tree. Member of the Brachychiton family. Good for water.
Good for water.
Yeah. Holds a lot of water, the bottle trees. Oh, little ones.
Yeah.
How cool is that? They're just as inquisitive as what we are. Oh, they're chasing each other.
Are there different kinds of kangaroos in Australia?
Oh yeah, there's five different species just here. And there's heaps of different species on that. Just have a little wander around, have a little read, and I'll set up afternoon tea.
All right. But
see, that's the trouble. We after Afghanistan and Iraq, I've changed my view on a lot of things. Imagine I rung you up and said, listen Marty, they're coming to get out of your house. You say, no, leave, I've just paid the house off, I've just got the pool put in, got the new sound system. So no, they're coming. Get out. What would happen to you guys in the Second World War? All we need to do is catch food. Somebody dry to sleep at the night time and be happy. And I'd be happy just living on a creek bank, just living off bush tuck.
You've got capabilities to live from the land. Then I would be here in the jungle in the bush and I would survive in 5 minutes.
But in Holland they must have lived off the land there before. Mine to get a half a loaf of bread. I've got too much pride for that. I'd just go out in the bush and catch something. Make my own bread. Righto, guys, we've got teas and coffees here, we've got scones, we've got freshly made jam and cream, and it's all happening.
was looking up on the hill, there's a little rock wall to be up here every now and then, but he's not there today. He's sitting up there in the crack, but he must be having to lay down somewhere else. They're wallaroos. That's a common female wallaroo. They have hair, they don't have fur. What's the pictures, guys?
Look at this here. See about my shoulder height, all the frothy lava?
Yeah.
That's the top of an old lava float. Then the smooth piece above it, that's the bottom of the next float. And then the frothy bit, the tops, that's one whole lava float. Then up above that, the smooth piece of the frothy bit shows another lava flow. There's three lava flows there. So just, yeah, evidence that the Undara wasn't the only volcano that run lava in this area, it's just the last one, 190,000 years ago. Australian bush, like that, you only need a splash of rain and it just greens up. It's just incredible.
Yep.
It's just amazing, the Australian outback. And even if you burn the grass out, it comes back green straight away without any rain.
So there must be some moisture left in there.
Yeah. These ones are going to bring the roofs down over the next, 300 or 400 years. They'll grow down the ground, they'll pick up nutrients out of the soil, and they'll smash the roofs out. Look down here, see there's a layer of lava across there?
Yep.
Then there's another layer here.
Yep.
Then there's another layer there, another layer here. Now as the lava flowed through the tubes, it also flowed over the top. So it didn't just go underneath, it went over as well.
Okay.
All that real shiny stuff up there is bacteria. If you actually climb up there and touch that, the water just repels water. So the water is up there and you're around.
Some say I'll be eaten, badly. But all our agree is to join the stampede. You should never take more than you give in the circle of life. Be proud.